Hello everybody, Sky Marshall here. Welcome back to another unboxing. It's going to be a quick unboxing. It's early Friday morning. I've had this box for about a week now, just haven't had time to do it. See, Hambone has released an unboxing similar of the 1914 game, and that's what we're going to do right now too as well. We're going to dive right in and open this bad boy up and see what we got. What is in this lovely little package. We got our standard tube, and is there anything else? Yes, there is. There is some other stuff. Look at that. Mystery box. Oh, come on. Okay. And maybe some player aids. Ooh, cool, and some rules, and that's it. We are done with that. So I'll have to take a look at this here and that and this. Let's just open this up quickly and see what we got in here. All right. So if any of you guys are watching and looking at getting the 1914 game, it's a mammoth game like 1936. It's on the historical board gaming website and random events table. This is rather cool. Spain joins the war. Fritz Klein, ABC Pact failure. This is cool. So basically when you roll 1 to 6 here for whatever event, it does a special thing where you'll either adjust some country's unit placement or change this or change that, and just adds a little bit of fun to the game, which just might put a small wrinkle in your plans, or might help out your plans. So that's cool. That's very cool. Victory chart. Ooh, I like these new victory charts. Just in general, your victory point system is based on this. So you got your objective cities up top here. You got Berlin, Vienna, Constantinople, London, Paris, Petrograd, Peking. Then, of course, you got German, or I guess the Central Powers objectives, as well as the Allies, and of course the Soviet objectives, if and when, I guess the Soviet does start to form, right? Which may give you that three-player option, right? So cool. That is very neat. Let's just look at the Ottomans here. Ottoman dynasty, score one victory objective for the control of each of the following: Bulgaria, Thessaly, Macedonia, Southern Persia, Northern Persia. Basically, it gives you direction for the Ottomans, which is nice, to build their empire, so to speak. So that is very cool. And we have a 4-stage building queue, which is probably a little bit realistic. Back in the old days, it took a little longer to build ships, such as pre-dreadnoughts, dreadnoughts, cruisers, and then, of course, your facilities as well. Nothing's really instantaneously built in this game, so that is cool. And diplomacy. This is cool. I like the circular version of diplomacy. You can see each major nation is on there, and if they can spend some IPP or just get their influence roll, you can see the Ottoman Empire has some on the outer circle. Same with France, which I think is maybe Bulgaria, or maybe no, sorry, not Bulgaria, Slovakia. Serbia, maybe. Anyways, regardless, it doesn't really matter. So yeah, that's kind of cool. Just in their sphere of influence. And then obviously once you progressively get closer and closer, you get some advantages, you get some trade IPP, the ports are open to you until it's part of your territory, sorry. And this is where they start out. So that's cool. And then of course they end up going towards whatever nation is influencing them. That's awesome. And diplomacy chart right here. So it just shows you all the nations on the diplomacy chart, alignment, if you can align them or if you can't align them within reason. Obviously Japan aligning Sweden doesn't make a lot of sense, you know what I mean, type of thing. Or the Ottomans trying to align Sweden. It's kind of odd. So, but that is cool. And then what do we have here? We have our income tracker and our date tracker. And you can see the prequels here as well as the main game and then the after sequence game there. So that was really cool. Mandatory offensives, as well as all your nations. And technology chart. Certain things in here, obviously. Gases, strategic bombers, a lot of flight stuff. Evolution of your fighter aircraft, because they were really just observational at the beginning part of the war. Q ships, convoy raiders, tanks, armored cars, armored vehicles. That's really neat. That's cool. And of course, they give us attack and defend value charts right here. A lot of infantry based. You got cavalry, elite cavalry. Not a lot of mechanized stuff in this game because it was the turn of the century, turn of the 20th century, and some boats and stuff like that. So a simpler setup. But nonetheless, very cool. Very cool. Okay, let's dive in and look at the map, shall we? If you can do that. I have this on my office floor here because I really don't know where else to put it. Being it's a 4x8 map. And my good friend, General Hand Grenade, was one of the main people in this setup, designing it and of course building it, and I think he's quite happy with the end result, and nice little feather in his cap, so to speak, of let's see here, there we go. So I think this is made of this new material that lays flat, which is nice. So we'll see how that works successfully once we get it out of the tube. And look at that. Very nice, very bright, very colorful. And we'll just open it up here on my office floor. 4x8. At least I think this should be a 4x8. Nice big piece of sheet of plywood. And what does it come with? Nice. Comes with a beautiful poster too inside here, and you got, I think, Will Henson, Doug Friend, General Hand Grenade, and some of the designers on this game, and I think their names are in the credits right there. There's Brian, and I think possibly Bob as well there too. So very cool. Congrats to those designers and developers for making this game, and very cool. Anyways, so let's roll that up. Don't even know what I'm going to do with that one day, but got to keep in a safe spot. And here's our map. Forgive the glare here as the sun rises early in the morning, but we'll just do a quick perusal. South America looks very similar in some ways. You got kind of your strict neutrals with our neutral nations, if you want to call them that. That are kind of that gray. You got Canada and the United States. You got the British Empire and so-called Far East Command, but obviously it's just part of the colonies. You got Australia, which I like that they have their actual flags. You got the South African Union, which is really just all part of the British Empire at this point. The beautiful Ottoman Empire right there. And of course we have the Austrians and the Germans. And the Russians, the Italians, which will either be part of this game or not, or should be part of one side or the other, and same with the Japanese, and all the Chinese warlords in this game as well. So, very cool, very cool. Definitely pick this game up. They come in three different sizes. I think 3x5, 3x6, something like that, 4x8, and 5x10, I believe. And obviously I've gone by the 4x8 for obvious reasons. Just makes a lot of sense to have that size of a map. But anyways, that is great, guys. That is awesome. Now there is one more box here. I'm assuming it is probably part of the game, or it could be an extra thing I had ordered here, and we'll just see what's in here. Ah, look at this. Here we go. We got our Chinese warlord deck. Right there, that's cool. And ooh, we got the diplomacy little icons there. Small, cute, neat little guys that you can put on your thing. And then of course you got your nations, which is very nice. And then right here, your trackers, possibly for your victory points, coasters for your nations, and battle labels. And cool, yeah, and just obviously your different nations in here to put your stuff together, to build your sets, and that is very cool. Very cool indeed. All right, guys, well, that completes this unboxing. Just a quick unboxing, not going to take too much of your time. Go grab your own game and go have some fun because the rules are out, and yeah, start building this game. You can get probably 100% of your pieces from Historical Board Gaming. Go support Historical Board Gaming's business and Doug Friend's business, and yeah, just get cracking and start this game. And I'm sure there's going to be some YouTube wars coming up for this particular game in the near future. Check out General Hand Grenade's channel on YouTube as well if you want to learn how to play this game. He's done a promo game by himself, step by step, and showing you the advantages and disadvantages of certain things and how you play it, order of play, strategies, so on and so forth. Take care, guys. Sky Marshall out.